Hello everyone, today our session is on problems of dimensioning practice, problems on dimensioning practice. If you missed my video on dimension practice, just first look at it today and you can get how the dimensions are being and how we have to denote like that. Okay, now if you remember from previous videos, what are the type of dimensioning systems we have? First one, parallel dimensioning, and then chain dimensioning, and then progressive dimensioning, and compound dimensioning, and coordinate. And many of the cases you can get chain and parallel as well as progressive dimensioning. Only in few cases they will ask compound dimension. Now let us look at into the first problem. See, what is the first problem? Recall the following dimension in chain and parallel dimension. In chain and parallel dimensioning. See, first one, see this is the first figure and this heading is for the both the problems. Second one also, same. Recall the following dimension in the chain and parallel dimensioning. See, let us look at into the first problem. See, this is the first problem. They given in chain and parallel dimension. As we discussed in the previous video, chain means, for example, any problem is there, you have to write in the form of C. For example, chain means I already said to you, it is in the form of chain, means you look it into your bicycles or cycles in your vehicles. Similarly, you can remember like that, which is interlinked with each other, beside each other, like that. That is an example of chain dimensioning. See, for example, if you look at it here, what is the dimension they gave in the problem? They given as, see, first one 15, and then see, if you remember from the previous video, if they give only single arrow, if they give single arrow from here, and next, if it is given in the single arrow, only single arrow in a dimension, then it is called as progressive dimension. Then it is termed as progressive dimension. So, by seeing this dimension, we clearly understand that they are given in the progressive dimension. So, we have to convert it into chain and parallel dimension. Now, let us redraw. See, so for example, if you look at, see, every length they given as 10 and the total length from here they gave 50. So, that from here it is increased 40 mm. See, if you consider here 10 mm, 1, 2, 3, 4. So, this is the total 40 mm and this one 50 mm. So, there might be a mistake. Now, already 10 mm over, so it should be 40 mm. The total length is, see, 10, 20, 10 plus 10, 20, 20 plus 10, 30, 30 plus 10, 40. 40. So here already 10 gone, so remaining is 30. 30 plus 10, total is 40. So, see, if here 10 mm is there and here 40 mm is there. Now, the length of this length, total length is 40 mm because in the progressive dimension they will give from top to the, from bottom to the top line. So, let us say, what is the length of the line? 40 mm. See, this is the 40 mm. And now, from here onwards, 15. Starting here, this is the 15. Now, again, what is the increment? 10 mm. This is 10 mm. Now, from here, it is 15 changed to 30. In progressive dimension, what we have to take? The value in the right side, it should be separated from this one. So, 30 minus 15. Here 30 minus 15. See, 30 minus 15 means it becomes 15 mm. From here, we have to take 15 mm. Again, what is the height? 10 mm. What is the height? 10 mm. Now, again, from 30 it increases to 50. So, that 50 minus 30. What is the value? 20. Now, again, 20 mm. And again, 30 mm. See, from here, the height is 10 mm. And again, from 50, the outermost value is 75. 75 minus 50. What is the value? 25. We have 13. Okay, now from here, straight from here, this is first value is 15. You have to take 15, and then next value is what is the next value? 30 minus 50 minus 30, 20. Next value is 20. Next, from here, what is the value? 50 minus 30 is 20. Max 1 minute. First one 15, next 15. Two times we are getting 15, and then 20, and last 25, and last is 25. The value is 25. Okay. If we arrows like this, 1:3 ratio, 1:3 ratio, you have to fill clearly in your notes or in your exam. This makes very good. Okay. First one, what is the value? Chain dimension. Okay. This is drawn in chain dimension. Now, parallel dimension. How we have to write parallel dimension? See, for this diagram, see, first one has been drawn here only. Okay, let me explain here only. Just note it down here. What is the value? 40 mm. From here, 40 mm. And then 15. And then 10. And then 15. And then 10. And then 20. And then 25. And like this. See, this is the diagram. Now, if you want to write in the parallel dimension, means what we have to do? First, what is the value? 15 mm. From here, question. 15 minus 0, 15. 15 mm. Because why we are doing subtraction from the next digit? Because it is given in the progressive dimension. Since it is giving only single arrow, then we have to consider it is as a progressive dimension. Now, first value is 15 mm. Next. Next one is in the next question, it is given as parallel dimension. Parallel dimension is what we have to do? For the single line, from here we have to take the next line. What is the next value? 15. What is the value? 15. And next, again, from here only, what is the next value? 20. What is the next value? 20. And what is the last value? 25. As we are denoting all the lines in the parallel, it is called a parallel dimension. I already discussed in the previous video. If you have any doubts, just look it into first video and then you can come back to the problems. Here. And here, parallel means first we have to draw 10 mm. And next, it is 40 mm. Okay? This is the first problem. Just note it down the answers if you have any clarification. I'm practicing in your A4 sheet so that it will be very effective. In the drawing, you have to first practice. Practice is the most important thing in the drawing. Even if I show you the answer, you cannot draw, because without practice, you cannot draw the figure perfectly. Okay, let us look at into the second problem. In the second problem, also say, redraw the dimension in chain and parallel dimensioning. See, first they given as indirectly. In this, they give the progressive dimension indirectly. In this problem also, they gave in indirectly 60:40. So, if you observe here, it is looking like a rectangle. It is in the shape of rectangle. Easily, you can say 60:40 means can write 60 here. No, because the horizontal line is very much bigger than vertical line. So you have to consider 60 horizontal and 40 here. Similarly, in this box it is given as 50:30. Now, if you consider this box also, we have to take 50 horizontal line and 30 here. This also same parallel dimension, chain and parallel dimension. Now, see what is the height? As we have drawn roughly on the figure, we have to take 60 mm horizontally. 60 mm horizontally. And what is the height? 40. Okay. Now, this is 40 mm. Again, from here, we have to take 60. This is 50. Continuation to this 90 yard gate, 50 mm. And then what is the height? 30 mm. And by joining this, you can get this rectangle box as given. Now, what are the dimensions we have to know? We know the following dimension in chain and parallel dimension. Chain is, as we discussed in the previous problem, it should be in the chain, in the form of chain. See, first one, what is the value? 60. And arrow should be in the 1:3 ratio. Next, this one, what is the value of chain? As we have denoted chain, it should be adjacent to each other. See, this is the 50 mm. And then here, what is the value of 40? So if you want to calculate chain, you can write directly only this side. First one is 30. And then next one is drawing a parallel line to this, and it should be adjacent to it. Okay, total 40 from here. Okay, you can denote here or else here. If you consider here 30, it will be 10 mm. Like that, you can denote like this, or else here also you can denote 40 mm. Okay, any either of the one you can denote. This is 30 mm and this is 40 mm. Like this also you can denote. Otherwise, from up to here 30 and total 40 means here also you can denote 10. This is the second problem. Okay, let us get into the third problem. See, redraw the figure in progressive dimension. See, if you look at it in the first problem, the question is given in a progressive dimension. But in this diagram, it is given in normal dimension, but it is wrong. If you observe here, see, the dimension should not be inside the figure. First point, the dimension should not be in the figure. If you look at it in this figure, it is in the shape of steps, but the dimension are given inside the steps. So it is wrong. You should not give a dimension inside the figure. One thing. And then another thing, given to redraw the figure in progressive dimension. Now let us draw this. See, for example, first one, this is 20 mm. 20 plus 30 plus 10. What is the full value? 20, 30, 50, 50 plus 1, 10, 60. So, the bottom line should be 60 mm. And then, what is the height? See, if you consider this one, this is the height of the length, last block. So, it should be 50 mm. It should be 50 mm. Now, from here, what is the value? 10 mm. And then, from here also you can take 20 mm and then 20 mm and then 40, and here also like that also you can complete the figure. But see, in this figure it should be joined here and this one also. These are different blocks which are coincided with each other. Now see, what we have to mention? Progressive dimension. See, starting from here, we have to take what is the value? 20 mm. And progressive dimension should be mentioned at the last of the line. See, if you see the question, see, first 0 and 15. If whatever the last line is there, it should mention at the end of the line. That is the correct method for denoting progressive dimension. First one, single arrow with right side. This is the 20 mm. And from here, 20 plus 30. What is the value? 50. From here, you have to take 50 mm. Now, 30 plus 10. 30 plus 10, how much? 60. This value is 60. Okay, now, coming to this side. Let us take the value of this side. First, what is the height of the first block? 20 mm. 20 mm, you have to denote here. Sorry. As we are denoting progressive dimension, we have to take only single arrow. This is 20 mm. And next one, drawing a parallel line, and from here also a parallel line. See, up to here, what is the value? 40. See, if you observe from bottom is telling, so you can write directly, because 20 plus 20, 40. You can write this 40 as direct, because it is mentioning from the bottom. Okay? We are also measuring from here. Up to 40 and here 50. Here one more arrow should be in the form of 1:3 ratio. we draw the figure in progressive dimension. In progressive dimension. See, as we discussed in the previous problem, see, the dimension should not be inside a figure, first point. And then, see, if you look at in this problem also, the dimensions are inside the figure. It is wrong. You have to take this 20 mm outside. And here also, we given 20 mm attaching to the figure. This is also wrong. And you should not denote this inclined dimension like this. You have to take it parallel lines and we have to denote. Only inclined dimension is allowed in the isometric views. Okay, we can discuss in the later classes. Okay, let us redraw the figure as given. See, what is the first, what is the height? 60 mm. It is 60 mm. Now, from here it is 80 mm. Okay? Now, from bottom it is first 20 mm and height 20 mm and 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 here also 20 mm and height like this and here 25 mm. This is the figure we have written on according to the dimensions given. Okay, we have already done. Then what dimension we have to give? He asked a question, read out the figure in progressive dimension. He asked to write in progressive dimension. Okay, from here, draw a parallel line. Draw a parallel line up to bottom. And then from here on, from every line, we have to draw parallel lines. So that it will be very easy. So what is our progressive dimension? First, what is the value? 20 mm. Progressive dimension is what we have to know? Only single side. Okay. What is here? 0 and here 20. And one more thing important is, starting from here, we have to denote 0 in progressive dimension. In progressive dimension, we have to denote 0 from the starting point. Next. Here, 0 to 20. And remaining from here to here, how much? He given 40. Okay, if he given 40 means 20 plus 40, how much it will become? 60. And 60 plus 20, 80. 80 plus 20, 100. This is the value of bottom. Now, what is the height? See, if you want to denote the height, here also, in single arrow, we have to denote 60. We have to denote 60. And then, now, from here, what is the value? It is also single side, so we have to take this 80. Or else, single 80, but you should not mention here. You should mention at the top of the line, here 80. As this is the progressive dimension, we have to mention in the top right corner. And here also, see, 20 and what is the value? Okay, total. See, this is the 25 and this is the 20. So, the remaining value will be here. It will be 15 mm. Did you get my point? See, total is 60 and first is 20. From here 20 and this is 25. 20 plus 25, 45. 60 minus 45, this is 15 mm. If you did not give an answer, you have to consider this as 15 mm. Okay. Now, from here, starting from, see, if I mention, already I have drawn the line. So it should not coincide the other line. Here even the dimension is coinciding with each other. But we should not do like that. So if you want to write the dimension of this, you have to take parallel outside and up to here and then up to here and then from here. So these are the dimension I am denoting in progressive dimensioning. See, first one. Starting here, 0. And what is the value? 20 mm, right? 20 mm. And then 20 plus 15, 35. Okay, 35. And then from here, 25. 25 plus 35, it is 60. And you should denote single arrow. And you should denote single arrow. Okay, let us look into some other problems. Okay, let's note it down. If you have any doubts, just note it down.